This episode is brought to you by Paramount Plus. Ewan McGregor stars as Count Alexander Rostov in A Gentleman in Moscow, the new limited series based on the best-selling novel. Stream it with the Paramount Plus with Showtime plan. Visit ParamountPlus.com to try it free.
Remember that weed I smoked last week when I was telling you how good it was? Actually, I was coughing on the motherfucking mic. Anyways, y'all, it's the Couch Chronicles, and it ain't no fucking limits. I do this every Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday from 8 Central Time. Make sure you follow Couch Chronicles No Limits on Spotify, Pandora, THA Couch on Facebook and TikTok. My main YouTube and Instagram, which is THA Real J-A-N-E-L-L. CouchChronicles.NoLimits on Instagram and THA Real J-A-N-E-L-L.com. Come on, Bella. We about to get started, girl. She loves when I put my hands like this and help her get up. Y'all, she's something else. Well, y'all already know I'm about to get the music started. That way I can start sharing the live. So if you're watching on YouTube, make sure that you hit the like button. If you're watching on Facebook, make sure that you share the live. It's Monday. The fuck? It is fucking Monday. And I definitely appreciate anybody that comes, watches, tunes in, keeps up with the couch. Like, that shit, that's real love. For real. And I definitely appreciate it. For sure. Let's go.
I appreciate the money cause I grew up in the struggle. Appreciate the hood cause it taught me how to hustle. Went through some hard times when I was down on my knuckles. I appreciate the ones who stuck around, just know I love you. Yeah. I appreciate them long days in the trap. Appreciate the road every time I made it back. I appreciate the hard tin and that white wine. A nigga play with me, he don't appreciate his life. Don't appreciate his life. And I appreciate the things that I've been through, cause it shaped me to be who I am. And I promise it's the truth. Handle my business, I'm counting my things, cutting off a couple niggas. They continue to make my moves, yeah, yeah, yeah. I got shit that I gotta do.
I got shit that I gotta do.
Play with me, you are a fool.
Keep playing with me, you gonna be lame. See, I'm trying to be nice, but you keep guessing my case and my baby. Something ain't right with this picture I see. So I cut you off to keep my end of truth. You say you love me, then why is there peace? Don't need you in my life, just wait and you'll see.
I appreciate the money cause I grew up in the struggle. Appreciate the hood cause it taught me how to hustle. Went through some hard times when I was down on my knuckles. I appreciate the ones who stuck around, just know I love you.
Yeah.
I appreciate the long days in the trap. Appreciate the road every time I made it back.
I
appreciate the hard tin and that white wine. A nigga play with me, he don't appreciate his life. Don't appreciate
if
his life.
Come to me, you better come with some respect.
Some respect.
In my feelings, I'm just telling you what's best.
Yes.
Keep it real, you got animosity. I'm not tripping, but you gon' respect me. I'm not stressing what you talking about.
And if my haters come through to make you walk it out,
make you walk it out.
You keep on rapping, people come back and tell me what you be saying. You got big if you for granted.
And I appreciate my real niggas,
real niggas,
my family and friends.
Friends.
The struggle only made me just be greater than I know. The people that surround me keep it real,
keep it real.
Cause half the ones I keep around, I'm
gonna
just
make the money cause I grew up in the struggle.
Struggle.
Appreciate the hood cause it taught me how to hustle. Went through some hard times when I was down on my knuckles. I appreciate the ones who stuck around, just know I love you.
Yeah.
I appreciate them long days in the trap. Appreciate the road every time I made it back.
I
appreciate the hard tin and that white wine. A nigga play with me, he don't appreciate his life.
Don't appreciate his life.
Appreciate his fucking life, man. Y'all already know what time it is. I'm trying to get the Facebook back on because it But anyways, y'all, it's the Couch Chronicles and ain't no fucking limits. I got Bella right next to me. I got Leo on the other side of me. Y'all see what I got on? First of all, when I say some fucking fire ass weed, I do not know why Leo has to be in my way. But y'all make sure that y'all check them out. I will be tagging them. Okay. Yeah, man. I wish I had some right now to smoke so I can just cough again and let y'all know how bomb they are. But y'all see it. Okay. It's a little big, but guess what? It doesn't matter. I'm still going to wear it. I already said that. Still gonna wear it on the couch. What up, though? Y'all make sure that y'all share it live if you watching on Facebook. If you watching on YouTube, make sure that you hit the like button. Y'all, I don't know what's going on with these two today. But we're gonna play one more song so I can share it live again on Facebook. Because like I said, it was tripping a second ago. So y'all already know what song that I'm gonna play. Because we can't make nothing up on this podcast. We can't make nothing up. So please do not think that somebody making something up. If they coming on this podcast to speak about something, they ain't making none of that shit up. We can't make this shit up. Okay. If you watching on Facebook, share it live.
Like I'm supposed to. Always tell the truth. I cross my heart and hope to die. This shit is crazy. What I go through. I can't make this shit up.
No, I can't make this shit up.
Today they are. What up, though? Y'all see what it is? Y'all, I really need to take this down because I keep hitting my head, really. Okay. Y'all, let me, hold on, let me. Don't judge me while I fix my cup of dreads real quick. Yeah, okay. Stop playing with me. Wait till I get some wicks. Stop playing with your girl. Fuck it, it's gonna have to look like this right now, cause yeah. What up, though, y'all? What up, though? What up, though? Man, I got some good stuff to tell y'all today, and so I'm starting back on news you can use on the couch, and also I want to start doing like birthday shout outs. So if you have anybody that you want to shout out for your birthday, for their birthday, send me a DM so I can write their name down. Also, do y'all remember back in the day when they used to do like Sunday night slow jams? And then every time on Sunday night slow jams, they would read emails. I want to do that. I want to do like a email read. Like, I don't give a fuck what you talking about. Like, I mean, I guess it it don't really matter because whatever you email, I'm going to start reading it out loud. So if you want to email the couch, I don't give a fuck what you talking about. If you want something to be said on the couch, just email me at Couch Chronicles No Limit. There's no S on the end of it because they wouldn't allow me to. So it's Couch Chronicles No Limit at gmail.com. I will make sure that I put it in the comments as well, or in the description as well. But it's Couch Chronicles No Limit at gmail.com. Now you can email me anything. Whatever you want said on the couch, as long as I don't have a guest, we're going to be doing emails, email reads. You can also email me if you have anybody's birthday that you want to, you know, give a shout out to, or if you just, I don't know, like a special shout out to somebody, or if there's something specific that you want to, I don't know. I think it'll be fun. I'm excited. And Couch Chronicles just started One Mic on the Couch, okay? Now, it's been a lot of people that's been like, oh, man, I missed it. No, you didn't miss anything. That's not what's going on. Let me tell you how it's going to happen. So, the way this is going to happen is, let me not say you, because you probably cannot freestyle. Now, I don't know if y'all remember back in the day when motherfuckers used to be on the side of the street beating, you know, you know what I'm saying? Niggas used to just be going, like, they didn't pull out no paper, like, hey, I'm a motherfucking dodge, the book is dodge. They didn't do that shit. They was just going. They was just going. So I want those people on the mic, like, because you only get one shot. And I don't mean, like, you only get one shot. Do not miss your chance to blow. I just mean that you shouldn't need 10 different times to do a freestyle. It's a freestyle. Like, you literally gotta be going off the top of the dome. Okay? Now, I will say this. For those that write, I will give you 30 minutes to listen to the beat and write something. But you're going to have to memorize that motherfucker. You got to remember that. You got to memorize that. You can't just think that you about to just, Hey, Brittany, I got your gift here. I need you to come get it. Or just let me know. I'll come bring it to you soon. So, now, this is the categories. If you're a rapper, you got a rap category. Actually, let me just tell y'all the categories. You got a rap category, like, a Detroit rap, you got a melodic rap style, you got R&B style, and you also have like a rock type style, like in a trippy type style. I even have some fun beats. Like, it's different type beats, and you'll get to pick from 5 different beats. You'll get to listen to each of them and figure out which one you want to go off on. And out of that, the one that you pick, if you are one of the ones that's going to be writing, you get to listen to that beat for 30 minutes. Now, listen to me. If you plan on writing it down and using your paper, just know this. I ain't mad at you. I'm not. You can use your paper. You can use your paper after you wrote it down. But just know this, that your recording, like, it's not going to be no recording, like, in the studio. No, I'm going to do a video of you. I'm going to edit it. It's going to look nice. Okay? It's going to have some transitions and shit. Okay? But it's just going to be you going off the dome. Like, you ripping that motherfucking mic. Now, here's the thing, is it's going to be 2.5 minutes. So, between that 2.5 minutes, whichever part sounds the best, you can pick it like that. I don't have to edit the whole video. You can pick which part you like the best, which one you, it's, or you can just go with it and just know that what you laid down is the best. He said, what if I'm just a writer? You gonna rap it for me? No, I don't want to enter the challenge. I want other people to do it. But it's, listen, it's, wait till I get the first person and y'all see what the fuck I'm talking about. Because I'm telling you, the vision is like, ugh, I can't wait till y'all. Wait, just wait. And another thing, it's free. I'm not even charging to do this. This is just something I'm doing for the couch. Like, something I want to do. Like, one, to bring unity. Two, to bring out that real motherfucking freestyle flow shit. Like, dog, I miss that shit. Like, I'm ready to hear that shit. Y'all remember that shit? Stop playing. So, I'm not charging. So, if you're an artist and you like, damn, she charged to be on the couch. I'm not charging to do the one mic. You just let me know what date that you available. And if I'm available, we gonna get it popping. We gonna get it popping. I really want to do it every Wednesday. I really want to. Every Wednesday and weekends. Like, if y'all get chance on the weekends. Okay, so it's gonna be every, I'm just gonna say it. That's what it's gonna be. It's gonna be every Wednesday. If you're an artist, you'll have an opportunity to hit the mic. One mic. If you are a real freestyler, you are going to be able to show your motherfucking craft the right way. Because you, now for the freestylers, you ain't going to be able to listen to that beat for 30 minutes. You're going to listen to it a couple times. And that's it. You don't need 30 minutes. You a freestyler. Is it? Like, what? So, I'm ready. I'm excited. I can't wait. This Wednesday starts the first mic. Like, who want to jump on the mic this Wednesday? I haven't had anybody say that they want to this Wednesday, so it's open. It's open. It's open this Wednesday. If there's an artist, tag an artist that you know can freestyle they motherfucking ass off. I'm not talking about they using somebody else's writing. I'm not talking about they got ghostwriters. I'm talking about that they can get... If I get them a beat, they gonna go crazy on that motherfucker. I want you to tag them. Tag everybody you know. This Wednesday slot is open. This Wednesday slot is open, so. Any artist that you know that can rip the motherfucking mic, like, it ain't motherfucking right. Okay. Ooh. Nah, for real, though. I'm trying to hear that shit. I'm excited. I can't wait. The vibes is going to be right. I'm telling you, like, the setting, I'm telling y'all, y'all going to be like, what? This is dope. Watch. I'm telling you. Trust me. You just watch. I got an opening for this Wednesday. This Wednesday. All right. That's all I'm going to say, y'all. It's the Couch Chronicles, and it ain't no fucking limits. I do this every Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday from 8 Central Time. Follow the Couch Chronicles on No Limits. Follow Couch Chronicles No Limits on Spotify, Pandora, THA Couch on Facebook and TikTok, CouchChronicles.NoLimits on Instagram, and my main YouTube and Instagram, which is THA Real JANELL. Also visit my .com. THA Real JANELL.com. If you want to support the couch, you can Cash App, PayPal, or Chime. Or you can hit the honeymoon funds if you want to support the honeymoon. We got $20 in the bank right now. Shout out to my donation the other day. If you would like to, you can send it to the Cash App or PayPal or Chime. Also, if you're on Facebook, I can also receive stars now. So you can send stars to the couch. If you watch it on Facebook, you can send stars. Hey, hold on. Let me get another song started. But, actually, I want to read you guys a couple things before we get some music started. One, I'm starting back on News You Can Use. I don't know if y'all heard me say that earlier. And also, I got word earlier today that there's a young man that has a security business. And he's looking for any female or male that is licensed to carry. So if you know anybody that is licensed to carry, female or male, that is looking for work, I want to say it starts at $20 an hour, $25. I'm not for sure. Don't give me the line, actually. But please hit me up. It's a really great opportunity. I know the guy personally who runs the security business, and he's looking for people. So if you know anybody that's licensed to carry in the Oklahoma City area or the surrounding area and they don't mind driving to Oklahoma City, DM me and I'll send you all the information that you need. Also, news you can use. Did anybody notice that there's a lot of police presence in the southwest part of Oklahoma City? Now, apparently, there's an ongoing investigation. Now, I've been hearing a lot of stuff lately about kidnappings and, just a lot of predatory shit, you know? I met a young lady who's actually going to be on the couch soon, and she's going to speak on it. Her daughter was recently almost victimized. So, and that's right here in Oklahoma. She said that there's an ongoing investigation. So I was just thinking, like, damn, I wonder if this is the same thing. But they saying that the kidnapping is, like in Oklahoma. I was looking for the information. I couldn't find it. She told me to look on a specific website, but I totally forgot what it was. And she's at work, so I didn't get a chance to text her and ask her what was the website again. But as soon as I get the information, I will news you can use that shit again. Not tomorrow, because I do have a guest. Jackson will be on the couch tomorrow, so make sure that y'all tune in. But I will let y'all know as soon as I know more details, because it's really serious and it's out here in Oklahoma, right in probably in your backyard. I mean, not literally in your backyard, but you know what I mean. It's crazy. You got to be careful. You know, I don't know if you guys have seen, this don't have nothing to do with the kidnapping, but I don't know if you guys have seen recent posts on, if you're getting abused in your relationship at home, call a friend and say, hey, do you have your makeup still for sale? And they have like different keywords and codes and stuff like that. Now, I know that everybody that watches is in a perfect relationship. You're not being abused or none of that. But heaven forbids that this ever gets to somebody that is being abused. If there's anything that I can do, this is what I want to do. If you send me a message like, is the couch all booked up for this month? I thought you had my slot available. Anything, I don't know, something outrageous, I don't give a fuck, but that's going to let me know. Just give me some type of code word. We got to come up with something. Just like the abuse. Just like if you feel like you're being any type, I don't give a fuck what it is. If you feel like you're going to harm yourself, text me. Do you serve cheese on the couch? I don't give a fuck what you say. Say something to let me know so I can do something to help. If there's a way that you can, find your person. That person that you can always call that will help in any given situation. You know, shit is rough out here. It's rough as fuck out here. Last night at a hooey, I thought it was a hooey, but it's Aloha. I think it's Aloha Bar, if I'm not mistaken. It was a deadly shooting, and that was on Southeast 29th. The man was shot and killed. Now, I looked it up, and his name was Justin, and coming to find out, it was a 21-year-old that did it. So, rest in peace to him and his family. Y'all, it's rough out here. Like, I know y'all want to go out and have fun, but I don't know if you guys know this, but when you drink, a a lot of times, and I'm not making excuses for anybody that's out there with a gun that's just shooting and killing people. I'm just saying, like, you cannot, you just never know what to expect from anybody. And you don't want to put it past anyone. You know, you can be going out thinking that you about to have a good time and then get shot in your fucking ass. I'm not kidding. I know that probably sounds crazy, but I'm dead ass. So stay safe when you go out. Stay safe when you go out. Whoever, I don't give a fuck. Look, even if you don't text your parents or whoever you have that person, I don't know, but I have, like, whenever I go out, I make sure that my wife knows my location is on. She knows everywhere I go. The fuck, like, make sure that you have somebody that you that knows your location at all times. You know, I don't give a fuck if you gotta take an air tag with you. But you gotta stay safe, and you have to be able to do something to keep yourself safe. So, even if you feel like you're the grownest motherfucker in the world, still text a friend like, hey, I'm at this address. I'm at this address. Even if you don't be like, if anything ever happens to me, just be like, yo, I'm at this address and I'm going by myself. And you my person, the fuck? Or they already know that they your person, so they not gonna have to even question once they get that address. They gonna know what's up. So make sure that you have that person. Please. Please. Man, stay safe. Friday night in Oklahoma City, Friday night, the Oklahoma City police arrested an Ohio man. Now, he was actually wanted for murder. Now, what's crazy is the fact that he came to Oklahoma. I don't know if y'all realize this, but this slogan is here for a reason. You come on vacation, you leave on probation. Or you leave after a fucking prison sentence. Like, bruh, this is not the place to come hide out. This is not the place to come be on the low. Because with that saying, is you come on vacation, you leave on probation, that just means that they actually looking for a reason to stop anybody. They look in specifically to make sure that you leave on probation. So be careful. Those are traps, baby. This is a trap. This, Oklahoma, this is a trap. They don't say that for no reason. It's hella motherfuckers that came to Oklahoma. And if I'm lying, I'm dying. They done came to Oklahoma and caught a case. It's hella motherfuckers. I know hella motherfuckers that done caught a case here. So when they say you come on vacation, you leave on probation, that means that you come into this state, they watching your ass. Especially if your tags don't say Oklahoma. Don't do it to yourself. Don't. Don't. This ain't what you want. They prison systems, they jail systems. Oh my god. They jail systems. They prison systems. This, not saying that every other jail system and prison system is the best. But y'all, this ain't what you want. This isn't, if you commit a crime, just do your thing over there, but don't go everywhere but Oklahoma. This is not it. This is where you want to come to start a family. Settle down. Start a life. This is not where you want to commit crime. Okay. If you're just now tuning in, it's the Couch Chronicles, and it ain't no fucking limits. Okay. If you're watching on YouTube, make sure that you hit the like button. If you're watching on Facebook, make sure that you share the live. Y'all follow Couch Chronicles No Limits on Spotify, Pandora, THA Couch on Facebook, TikTok, CouchChronicles.NoLimits on Instagram, and my main YouTube and Instagram, which is THA Real JANELL. If you would like to support the Couch, you can Cash App, PayPal, or Chime. Or if you're on Facebook, you can send stars. THA Real JANELL. Okay, so this is the honeymoon fun jar as well. $20 was donated the other day, and it is now in the bank. So if you would like to donate, our first donation came the other day. So if you'd like to donate, tap in. I love y'all. I hope y'all having a good day. If y'all fucking with the couch, make sure that you drop them couches. If you one of the ones that come back and rewatch the couch, shout out to you. You're the real MVP. For real. Also, make sure that you check on your strong peoples. Check on your people's peoples. And even the ones that you like, damn, I ain't heard from that motherfucker in a couple days. Check on that person. You better check on them. For real, because you never know what they going through. That they might need whatever you gonna say to them that day. They might need that. They might. So make sure that you do that. Check on your peoples. Let them know that you love them. Let them know that you love them. Check on your peoples that's in the hospital. Do a wellness check. Do a wellness check. Y'all know why I started my podcast was because of my hospital visit. So make sure that you do a wellness check if you know anybody that's in the hospital. If you know anybody that's locked up, write them. Write them. All you got to do is download the Amelio app, and it's absolutely free to send a postcard. You can also send pictures as well. So write your peoples, check on your strong peoples, and your funny peoples, and your married, and your single peoples. Okay? And your peoples that's in relationships. Check on all your peoples. Let them know that you love them. Okay? Because time, life is short. We living in our last fucking days. I'm not going to lie. We are. And you don't want to leave this earth or them leave this earth without them knowing how you really felt or, you know, without checking on them. Like, man, somebody told me today, you know what? My closest friends don't even check on me like this. I was like, oh, damn. I ain't seen my, like, I just was, something was just tugging at my heart. Like, let me just reach out to my homie. Like, so if you get a random message from me, or you see me just randomly blowing you up on Facebook, don't send me the voicemail. That's just crazy. Don't send me the voicemail because I'm calling to check on you. I want to make sure that you're doing good. Okay? So, I'm just saying. Make sure your peoples is doing good. Shit. Motherfuckers right now got, you know how many people got cut off on their food stamps? I know I did. Shit. Times is hard. Money is funny and change is strange. I get it. So, for those that got their food stamps cut off, motherfuckers like, wait. Now, I was getting the, not me, but they was like, I was getting the steak. Now, I think I'm going to have to get the turkey meat. You know what I'm saying? And turn it into a steak. See, now, it ain't cheap being vegan. It's not. It's not at all. But I'm not mad. I ain't gonna stop. It ain't gonna stop me. It is not gonna stop. Y'all, it's the Couch Chronicles and there ain't no fucking limits. Let's jump right into another song. Y'all ready for it? Y'all ready for it? I hope so. Let's see. We gonna play Shit Talk. Cause make sure that, listen, if y'all haven't already downloaded Shit Talk, featuring my girl Pretty Eyes. Let me get her. Hold on. What up, though? It's your girl Pretty Eyes. If you haven't checked out my single Shit Talk, then you need to go get that right now. My girl Janelle is about to play it right here on her Couch Chronicles, and it ain't no fucking limits. All right. All right, I'm back, y'all. I had to let her take over for a second. I know y'all probably like, wait a second. Did she just lean over? And so it looked like I leaned over, but I leaned over, and Pretty Eyes came out. Yeah. So you judging me? So you judging me? You judging me? Shit talk, y'all.
Hey. Yeah. Pretty Eyes, bitch. Let's go. Let's go. And I ain't even drunk yet. I'ma get that. I'ma get that. I'ma get that. I'ma get that. I'ma get that bag, 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 bag.
Bitch,
I'ma get that bag, 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 bag. Yeah. I gotta get it, man. I gotta get it, man. I gotta get it.
Yeah, I gotta get it.
I gotta get it, man.
I gotta get it.
That bag, 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 bag.
Okay.
I get that bag, 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 bag. Woo. Get back, little bitch.
way. I be getting straight to the bag. Getting shit I ain't never had. Now I'm making niggas hella mad when they hear my beat. It's like a heart attack. Okay. Like, I know you mad though.
I do. I see you sad, yo. I see.
I've been all up in my bag, bro.
I have.
Now you looking like a sad hoe. Now it's time to get active, get in my mode, and get in my habits. The switch is really kind of ravish, and turn me straight into a savage. Goddamn.
I'ma get that, I'ma get that,
I'ma get that, I'ma get that, I'ma get that, bag.
Let's go, let's go.
Yeah, okay. I gotta get it.
I do.
I gotta get it.
I do.
I gotta get it.
I do.
I get that bag.
Yeah.
I get that bag.
I get it.
Okay. Little bitch. Right. Money always on my mind. Give it to me for my Valentine's. Please don't come in here without a dime. Cause if you in my face, you paying for my time.
Okay.
Right. I gotta get it. Yeah, I gotta get it. Yeah.
I do.
I get that bag.
I get it.
I get to that bag.
Yeah.
I get the bag.
I get it. Straight to the bag.
I get that bag.
It is the Couch Chronicles, and it ain't no motherfucking lemons. Hey. If y'all don't already know, that's Shit Talk. It's on all digital platforms. All you got to do is type in J-A-N-E-L-L and Shit Talk. Y'all go run that bitch up. Shout out to everybody that has been running it up. So if y'all don't know, then I'm going to have to let y'all know again. Okay. So for those of you that have friends that's artists, that's making music, let me tell you how you support them. Because you run that shit up every day. You know how you got your playlist and it's filled with like John Legend and Alicia Keys. You know what I'm saying? When it's filled with all of that, but it ain't filled with your people shit, that's a problem. I'm sure you got a friend that's in one of those genres. Okay, you only want to listen to slow music? I got some of that. They do too. Run it up. I'm just saying. Hit the like button. All you got to do to get their algorithm up is comment on their shit. Go comment on all their shit. I don't give a fuck if you put the shit emoji. Fuck it. Do it. Run they shit up. But on mine, you can put the couch, the fire, the microphone drop, or you can put that little head that's like, you know that little head? It's like, it's the new emoji. Has anybody seen it? It's like, maybe the arms ain't like that, but the head is like, and then y'all probably don't know that the head is shaking, but it's got the bulls. Okay. Anyways, back to news you can use. I definitely will tell Matt. Back to news you can use. There was a deadly fire just, I want to say it was this morning. It was right here on my side of town. So, seriously. What's the email? So, okay, yeah. My email is actually use a... MS Pretty Eyes 456 at gmail.com. You can use that. Actually, if you would like to, I'm doing a one mic on the couch. If you want to be one of the producers that I'm using your beat, is that what you're sending it for? So we can listen to it? Or is it music? Let me know. Because I don't normally play. Yes, tomorrow is our day. I don't normally play artist music on the couch unless they on the couch. But if it's a beat, we doing beats. Nothing on it, just an instrumental, just a boop, bop, bop beat. Okay. Hey, it's the Couch Chronicles. But, so the man that lost his life, y'all, rest in peace. I didn't get to tell y'all that, I don't think. But that happened right up the street from here. Also, there was a man taken into custody for killing his wife. Actually, in Bixby. Now, first of all, it's a white couple. And the reason why I mentioned it is because a lot of times I don't never see like the outcome of stuff like this when it comes to white people. Now, let me stop. Some cases. So I really want to see if something's going to come about with this case. It's some cases that's out here that get away with a lot of shit. And I don't hate to say it, but it's the fucking truth. And it just is what it is. So I'm curious to see what happens. Did anybody hear about the two bodies that they found in Fort Gibson Lake? It was two brothers. So first of all, rest in peace. Imagine just trying to hang out with your brother or your sister and like, hey, let's go diving into the lake, thinking that you about to just go have a good time and you end up losing your life. That shit is heavy. I know the family is going crazy, so my heart goes out to the family as well. Every family it's been a lot of deaths this week. I don't know if y'all noticed, but we definitely are living in our last days, and it's definitely signs. Now, y'all might be like, oh my God, listen to Janelle on the couch. Fuck you. Listen, this is for real. Like, the Mandela effect is real. Like, it's shit that's going on around our face, in our faces, and they like telling us, hey, this is not piss, knowing that they pissing on us. Like, they doing shit like, and like, we supposed to just be like, oh, okay. And a lot of us is going to be like, oh, okay, because they don't want to look into it. But I was about to say, now Facebook trying to reconnect. Like, they ain't trying to hear that shit. Uh-oh, did they take the stars away too? No, I'm playing. Oh, shit. Now, they don't want to hear that. Now, I will say this. It's a lot of stuff. No, 456@gmail.com. It's a lot of stuff that has been said recently on the couch about prison talk. Shout out to everybody that was on the couch, actually, that was on for prison talk. But I recently did a segment with Demetrius, and they muted his sound. And so I had to appeal it, and I'm like, I shouldn't have to appeal us talking. We didn't even curse in the video. So I'm like, why should I have to appeal us talking that real shit? This is the third time they've done that to my prison talk video. And I'm like, so I have to appeal what we're saying. So y'all have AI just listening for what? What keyword was it? I'm trying to figure it out. Yeah, so... Was anybody affected by the bomb threat that happened the other day? I know y'all probably like, what? The bomb threat? Yeah, it happened in Target. And they definitely evacuated a lot of people. They had it on the news. They had, like, what blocks they evacuating. And now, I don't know if anybody is aware of this, but Target, I don't shop at Target no more. So the reason why I don't shop at Target no more is because they are coming out with this line. If they haven't already came out with it, that's all about hating gays, getting rid of gays, ridding the earth of gays. Like, what the fuck are y'all doing? Like, they are literally slowly becoming, I don't fucking know. Like, I'm not even as mad about the satanic shit that they got coming out. I don't give a fuck. Listen, it's the hate, because some kids can be raised atheists, and that's just how their family raised them. So you can't be upset that you see some satanic clothes in Target when there are actually kids that wear that. But to be teaching your kid actual hate, hateful shit to say, like gays don't belong here or F the gay, like seriously, you're literally teaching your kids that. Like, it's bad enough that the adults are doing it, but you're teaching your kids that? Let's be for real. So that's why I don't shop at Target anymore. So I was wondering if that's what the bomb threat was about. They didn't really give detail on what it was, or... So I was just like, damn, I wonder if that's what it was, because that just recently happened. And now all of a sudden y'all getting bomb threats? Of course, some motherfucker gonna try to blow y'all up. Yeah, they not. Yeah, so I was just like, damn, I wonder if that's what it is, because it makes sense. It would make sense. It would make fucking sense that the reason why they getting bomb threats is because they are planning on coming out with a whole line that's hate towards LGBTQI community. And you know how big that community is? Okay, let's not play. Y'all, it's the Couch Chronicles and it ain't no fucking limits. If you're just now tuning in, thank you. I love you. I love all of y'all. Keep tuning in. If you don't get a chance today, get a chance soon. If you haven't already done so, follow the Couch Chronicles No Limits on Spotify, Pandora, THA Couch on Facebook and TikTok, CouchChronicles.NoLimits on Instagram and my main YouTube and TikTok and.com. It's THA Real JANELL. Shout out to everybody that's tuned in. Shout out to everybody that tunes in and comes back and watches on their break. Shout out to everybody that watches while they're at work, that listens on Spotify and Pandora. Yo, thank you. For real. Like, I noticed that my views and my streams and stuff is going up, and I'm definitely appreciative. So, seriously, shout out to y'all. I love y'all from the bottom of my heart. And really, I wouldn't even be here without y'all. You know what I'm saying? Because y'all keep me going. Wait. Seriously. And my wife is one of my biggest support. Like, oh my God. Shout out to everybody that supports me. Shout out to everybody that supports themselves. Shout out to everybody that encourages the people. Okay? Encourage your people. Man, depression is real. Times is hard. For real, you just never know. You never know. One word might save somebody. One thing you might, one little thing, one gesture. I dare you to send a dollar, just a random dollar, and a message to anybody in your Cash App. I dare you. Just a dollar. That's it. $1 and a beautiful message. Because they give you an option to send a message. $1 and a message. And a couch symbol. I dare you. I don't know. If you do, you do. If you don't, you don't. Y'all, it's the couch. Like I said. The couch. T-H-A. The fuck? That's Negro spelling if you didn't know. Now, you know how many people... That's why I had to stop saying that. Because people actually started typing Negro spelling and then the information. So that's why, if y'all notice, I don't say Negro spelling anymore. Because people would be like, okay, Negro spelling. I'm like, no, it's in Negro spelling. Like, that's the language it's in. You know, Negro. T-H-A. Yeah. So, I had to stop saying that, y'all. Don't get it twisted. It's still the Couch Chronicles and ain't no fucking limits. It's just that people... I hate repeating myself. I'm a Taurus. I hate repeating myself when it comes to stuff like that. What? T-H-A couch and Negro spelling. Okay, Negro spelling and what else? Okay, you trying to be funny. So, you typing in Negro spelling? Okay. One, I love y'all. I'm going to go ahead and play one more song. I got some more news you can use, but I'm going to wait for tomorrow for this. No, not tomorrow, but the next day for this, because I got a lot of shit. I wrote down a lot of shit. And we actually, after a couple songs, I might even be able to still say some stuff. But I do want to give a special shout out to Lupe and Sunny Lanes for the Battle of the Sexes event that they threw last night. I heard that it was a success. If I'm not mistaken, I want to say the prize went to me and my chick. I could be wrong, though. I could be wrong. So please, if y'all do know who the winner was last night, tag them. I want to give them a congratulations. That's dope as fuck. Y'all keep doing y'all motherfucking thing out there, for real. If you're an artist and you're in Oklahoma City, keep on doing what the fuck you doing. Do not stop. I don't give a fuck what nobody say. I don't give a fuck what the fuck you heard. You keep doing you. Don't stop. Keep pushing that shit. If it sound trash to somebody right now, guess what? Keep on perfecting that motherfucker to where it sounds golden. You hear me? Get that motherfucker golden. Mix and mastered to perfection. Don't worry about how much you're spending on your craft, because it's going to pay off in the long run. If you want a singer, pay for the singer that you want. Pay them for their craft. If you want your stuff mixed and mastered, pay for what you want. Get that shit mixed and mastered. Get it right. Get it right. Get it right. Get it tight. Get it right. Get it right. Get it tight. Hey, hold on. Okay. But for real. you listen. We need to start doing more things in unity out here. I seen that Battle of the Sexist list, and I was like, damn, how did they pick this list, though? Which I'm not mad. But I was just, no, not saying that I wanted to be on the list. I was just like, damn, it's hella motherfuckers that's out here. Y'all chose these motherfuckers. It's hella motherfuckers. But I still, like I said, I don't know how they went about the list. But y'all, we need more unity out here. Just the other day, Cudi just was saying on the podcast that it's a lot of unity in Atlanta. You know, it's a lot of stuff that goes on. The only difference, she said the same thing goes on out there, except it's more unity out there. So we need more unity. We need more, it's because it's a lot of separation and y'all know it. Like, what? Stop crossing people. Stop burning bridges when one day all the bridges is going to be broke and bust it down, and it's only one bridge to go over, and it's going to be theirs. Relax. We all want to win. For real. Don't burn bridges. Build them. Help fix them bitches. You see them motherfuckers start breaking down, you help fix them motherfuckers. We a team. We a team. We supposed to be. It's the Couch Chronicles, and there ain't no fucking limits. I'm just saying. Y'all already know what time it is, man. If y'all haven't already heard, I Can Get featuring JDSM. Make sure that y'all go check that shit out, too. Okay. Humble Minds Music. Actually, shout out to Humble Minds Music, too. Okay.
Shots I'm wasted, but I'm still headed to your spot so I can lay it down. Hope you got nobody around. I'm trying to show you what I'm talking about. This shit is crazy how I'm feeling, and I don't know what you're thinking, but I'm willing to do anything for you, and that is the truth. Boo, I'm right up for you. Make love and you fuck me right. I look you in your eyes cause you got it. As soon as you see that it's wet, that's when it's causing some problems. And we got them, but it's nothing, cause we always end up fucking. Yeah, I can get nasty, I can be a freak, I can't get dirty, but baby, you never leave me. You would always wanna see, you would rub me like a G. I can get nasty, I can be a freak, I can't get dirty, but baby, you never leave, You would always wanna see, you would rub me like a chick.
My favorite topic is you. Intrigued by your ways and the shit that you do. This an incredible view. I like how you screaming, you never mute. I'ma hit all of the spots. 40 degrees, it don't matter, it's hot. That pussy be creamy, it's not. I swear I'ma catch every drop. I'm talking about lick it up. Your lips probably weak, but gon' get them up. Is you lit enough? Can you switch it up? Gon' give it up. Is it big enough? Can I fill you up with determination? Burning nation. Your body is mine, can I learn to trace it? That pussy divine, I won't burn it waste. She riding that face, so I have to face. Whoa, let's get to the bottom line. You mighty fine. Your oil look better than dollar signs. I'm down with the dude if you tired of trying. If you down to bond, I might get carried away. I like the pearl in my
my face. I grip and twirl at your waist. I'ma just show you today.
I can get nasty. I can be a freak. I can be a freak. I can't get dirty, but baby, you never leave.
Now, all day Sunday, I think, I already told y'all, I'm going to do it every Wednesday, and then I'm going to do weekends, but y'all got to let me know on the weekends, because I do want to do my thing on the weekends, too. So, but it shouldn't take y'all that long. It's a one-take Jake thing. One mic on the couch. If you're interested, hit me up. It's absolutely free. If you're an artist and you think you got that motherfucking flow, let me see how you motherfucking go. Yeah, okay. Or if you're a poet, you can do a poem. I throw a beat behind that motherfucker. I'm not playing. You're going to get to going like flow a tree. Stop playing with me. Yeah. It's about to go down on the couch. I'm about to have more activities. I'm about to have some giveaways. Like, I'm telling you, like, I'm about to start having some shit going on. So, if you're not supporting the couch now, you might want to start supporting now. I'm gonna give you the opportunity to come back around and start supporting. But don't wait till it's too late. For real. Juneteenth events start on the 13th. If y'all don't already know, it will be a lot of events going on. I will be making sure to put the flyers on the page. So, make sure that you watch the page. I will be at the Fandango all day Sunday. So, and catch me emceeing at 1 p.m. from 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. At the Fandango Event Center. Make sure that you guys come out and support the Juneteenth events. We don't celebrate the 4th of July. We do celebrate Juneteenth. Stop playing. I do want to say this. I'm going to finish off the rest of the news you can use, because it is something I want to say. I don't know if anybody read the article about the woman that, there was a neighbor that was messing with, one of the kids that was a neighbor, another neighbor. So the woman was white and she was messing with a black, I want to say it was either a little girl or a little boy. And, around the last time that she was messing with them, she ended up taking a tablet and not giving it back, either not giving it back or throwing it and breaking it. So the mom went over there to go talk to the lady about what she did. And as soon as she knocked on the door, the lady shot and killed her straight through the door. I don't know if anybody has read about that, but my heart goes out to the family. The kids. Oh, my God. Y'all just please keep them in prayer. For real, because that is a deep situation. And I pray that situation is some justice to it. Seriously, I pray there's justice to it. A U.S. Olympian, Tori Bowie died from complications at birth. Rest in peace, Tori. There's a lot of deaths going on lately. I don't know if anybody, you know, is into, like, spiritual, anything deep spiritual. If y'all look at that as a sign, let me know. Leave me a comment. I won't go into details. Did anybody watch Conor McGregor punched the Miami Heat mascot? Yeah, so now, and the reason why I brought it up is because a lot of times when stuff like that happens, they do not punish the person doing the punching. But y'all see how they condemned the fuck out of Will Smith? Y'all seen that? Come on now. And he didn't punch. He open hand slapped. That was a bitch slap. But this man actually knocked this motherfucker out. Knocked the mascot out in front of everybody. Just as bad as the Oscars, right? What's the difference? Except Will Smith is black. And the other man is white. Oh, Connor. Did anybody see the fight with Jocelyn Hernandez? So I don't never really keep up with that, but I did see the fight and I was just like, damn, who the fuck is this throwing down like that? Well, she got arrested because it ended up becoming a deadly fight. And not only was it a deadly fight, but it was at Floyd Mayweather's fight. So fight on fight on fight on fight. Wow. That's crazy. Y'all, that's the end of news you can use for today. It's the Couch Chronicles and there ain't no fucking limits. Y'all, I do have some, I have some shows coming up in Texas. 3 shows, actually. It's in the description. Make sure that you read the description. But I do know July the 30th is the DallasBET Awards. Also, I have another one coming up in August. August the 2nd. Yes. So 2 in July, actually. In August the 2nd. So I got some stuff coming up for the couch and for my music as well. So I got some new music coming out soon. I'm going to give y'all an opportunity to choose my next single. So I'll let y'all choose my last single before. So let's do it again. I like how that turned out. I want to do it again. Y'all, it's the Couch Chronicles and it ain't no fucking limits. I love y'all so much. I will see y'all tomorrow on the couch with Jockton. Y'all, I can't wait. Y'all, it's about to be some shit going down on the couch, man. It's the Couch Chronicles and there ain't no fucking limits.